Welcome children, I welcome you all in the new session of class 12th A and congratulations to all those students who could make through their class 11th standard to class 12th standard and those students who could not make it to class 12th need not to get disordered. They are suggested and if they work a little harder for this time given which is given to them for to prepare their compartment exam, they will clear it and they will also join us in the same session. So children, class 12, as we have already begin with the chapter solid state and notes already being circulated in the class WhatsApp group, here I am to make you explain a few things which are really required for a interactive session. Here I will be discussing the 7 types of unit cells. Unit cells means what? If you see a full match box in which you can say ki this kind of a pause. So children, if this is my crystal, the complete crystal lattice, which is made up of small cubes like this. So repetition of these cubes in 3 dimension for infinitely long distances, I will get this kind of the complete crystal lattice. So this is our cube. And this cube is characterized by its edge length. These 3 edge lengths we will have: the height, the width, and then the length. Fine. So these 3 edges will be named as A, first edge length, B, this one, and C, this one. The 3 edge lengths. Now coming to the axial angles. The angle between 2 edge lengths, here this one. This is A, and then this one is your B, and then this one will be your alpha, beta, and this one is gamma. 3 axial angles and 3 edge lengths. Once again children, I am repeating, the 3 edge lengths 1, 2 and 3, 3 axial angles alpha, beta and gamma. So based on the characteristics of edge lengths A, B, C and interfacial angles, also called as axial angles alpha, beta and gamma, which are generally 90 degrees in simple cubes. Now here we will be discussing the simple unit cells, that means the properties of these unit cells, how many kinds of these unit cells could be. So this is the one simple cubic. One of them could be primitive. Primitive simply means they will have only the particles at the 8 corners. First, second, third, fourth corner, fifth, sixth, seventh and eighth corner. So all those cubic cells, all those cubic lattices, which cubic unit cells which have particles only at the corners and nowhere else, is termed as primitive. Such kind of simple cubic cells will have all the 3 edge lengths equal and the axial angles equals to 90 degree, and the examples are sodium chloride and zinc lead. Next may be the body centered. Body centered simply means what? Apart from having particles at the 8 corners, the cube will have one more particle at the center of the body of this unit cell. If we make a hollow space between in this space, and I insert one particle at the center of this unit cell, it will give rise to the body centered unit cell. Again, for that particular same, the other properties of the unit cell are going to remain the same. That is, all the 3 edge lengths will be equal, the 3 axial angles will be equal to 90 degree. Another one is possible, the face center. Simply means apart from having the 8 particles at the 8 corners, 4 bottom and 4 above, The unit cell will have one particle at the center of each face. This one, one here, then again one here, again one on this side, again one on this side and this side. So how many extra particles? These are 6 extra particles. It will give rise to face-centered unit cell. All the other properties going to remain the same. Next is the unit cell of the type of tetragonal. Tetragonal means simply says this type of unit cell will have the two edge lengths equal, first and second. These two edge lengths are equal. The third edge length will not be equal. It may be more, it may be less. Fine. The again, the three axial angles, first, second and third, the three axial angles still maintaining 90 degrees. It may have the primitive, simply means having no other particles other than the 8 corners, and it may be body centered, having one more extra particle at the center of the unit cell. Body, center of the body, not on any of the faces. And the examples of this are